Hello everybody, and this is Narendra Kumar, and today we have got a title in the series Life of Romance and Marriage, and the title is It is Lovely to be in Love. So in this write-up, in this essay, I have tried to express, it's a kind of prose poetry in which I've tried to express what is really involved, what happens when we love, when we fall in love. Love, it is a strange thing. We hear about it from childhood. We feel we kind of know it, what it is. But when we actually, truly fall in love, it is so lovely, so true, so filling you with happiness of such a true kind, wanting to be with your soulmate so badly and always. It is so unbelievably nice, so new to you, that it is not even perceived as love. You know, that is the point here. Love has happened and you don't know it is love. It is too good to be called anything, to be even shared. What do we say? It is so enigmatic that no words fit. And you cannot call it anything. You are just so happy. And it is always, always love at first sight. You see your girl, and it is a shocking feeling. That strange sense of her being like you in a strange way. And then it does not matter whether she is fair or dark, whether she is thin or fat, even old or young. She is just too beautiful and the nicest thing to you. You sit together and you talk. You want to talk. You feel it unbearable to separate. You feel so completely relaxed and comfortable only with her. You talk. You sense each other. You are understood in a strange harmony of being. A strange oneness you feel. You want to be only with each other. And it is mutual. You feel so good, both of you. And that is why fights too happen. And the pain too is so good. A pain that is felt because there is longing. And the clearing of the misunderstandings actually makes you realize the depth of love. The pain, the sweet pain, deepening the love, making you realize, shockingly, that there is no getting away from her, that it is life, her or death without her. And you accept it. As you like to be trapped, the trap, and the prison, that is not a prison at all, but the greatest freedom you feel, the greatest happiness you get. And who would want to go away from happiness? Who would care then about silly put-ons? Everything melts. It is a surrender, but it is an elevation too. But you don't know it. You're simply too happy, and you know that without words. Days pass and the love grows. The pain and the meeting, an extreme joy. The pain again, and then the joy again. And then you wonder what it is, what is happening to you, and slowly you talk about it. The love is not cheap, of course. You think about her in physical terms too, but not in a physical sense, but in a wondering sense. And then one day you hold hands. It happens inevitably, and you had never known how nice and wonderful it can be. You feel now to be hit by a kind of emotion that seems to have no limits. You don't know that that is called by a name, ecstasy. You don't know it, but you are filled obviously with it. Now the love becomes solemn, steely, kind of violent, and slowly the passion pours forth. You have dirty thoughts, but they are so beautifully and enticingly dirty. Nights are filled with the pain. You want her in the night, all the night. And you fantasize, you will do this and you will do that. And you sleep and no sleep comes. Nights of insomnia, thinking about how it would be with her, meeting her the next day, the agony and the ecstasy, the swing and the calm, and the swing of pain again. You are so happy in pain and happiness both. And finally, you both know it can't be stopped. It happens. you accidentally touch, brush against her breasts one day, or her lips or her cheeks, and you gasp. You are filled with a shocking feeling, so extreme that you cannot contain it, out of this world, and you finally realize, what is love? You find secret places, and you are filled with the hunger. The ecstatic union happens again and again. The seal is complete. The intimacy is full to the brim. The oneness is complete. You both have entered a heaven where only two can enter. It is an upheaval. All things mundane have been wiped out. You have become too serious, sincere, saintly in soul, passionate in body, muted in love, can't give words, and sweating and screaming in lovemaking. An unbelievable, earthly, heavenly happiness found, and chasteness is yours, and purity. The body has become a strange instrument to give your soul the highest happiness. And you are married before you get married, married in soul, in mind and heart, and later legally too, obviously, and a new meaning found in life. Life lived anew every day, and days pass in pure joy, and months, the strangest thing, the love, does not get lessened, but gets intensified. Even the other values surface. There is reason to use reason in work, in life. You release your dreams, your visions. You fly. You seem to have got an infinite power to achieve. And you do. You discover joy in life, in love, in work, in living. There is no working for its own sake, but working for living in mind and body. The love paves a philosophy. Without words, you two are in heaven, on earth, and you know it. And you don't too, as you don't need to know anything. It is lovely to be in love, my dear. Is it not? So that is the essay, the complete expression of what I believe is possible to all of us. Thank you so much. This is Narendra Kumar, and we are from NRK Academy.